What is up, guys? My name is Mario, and on this video, we're going to unlock the ZTE Zmax Pro for MetroPCS and get it ready for the T-Mobile network, and we're going to go over my experience. So make sure to stay tuned until the end of this video. If you have your ZTE Max Pro for over 90 days, you should be able to unlock it very easily. All you have to do is go to your app drawer, locate the app called Device Unlock. Once the app is open, click on the Permanent Unlocked, and after a few seconds, you should get a success message. If you do get a failure, it means that you haven't had your phone for over 90 days, or there is some issue with the account linked to the phone. Do pay attention to the details in the errors, because if your phone is already unlocked, you will get an unlocked fail, but in the details, it will mention that the device is already unlocked. Once the phone is unlocked, make sure to turn off the device before proceeding to removing the Nano SIM card by popping out the SIM tray. Remember to check your phone's box, as you should have received a tray eject tool. Once we remove the MetroPCS Nano SIM card, we proceed to inserting the T-Mobile Nano SIM card. After turning the device on, you should be connected to the T-Mobile network using the inserted Nano SIM card. Next, you'll want to go uninstall or disable all the MetroPCS apps. Don't worry, you can always get them back if you ever want to use this phone again with MetroPCS. You can disable the MetroPCS apps by navigating to your apps tray, clicking the settings app, and clicking on the apps tab. You will get a list of all the apps installed on your device. So what you want to do here is go through the list and identify all the MetroPCS apps. Once you find an app that you want to disable or uninstall, click on it, and on the next window, you will have an option to disable it or uninstall it. Remember that you can always come back and enable the apps following the same steps. Now, if you're wondering if the T-Mobile apps will be compatible, I can tell you that I tested three of the apps that I used the most and they worked as expected. The apps I tested were the T-Mobile app, the Visual Voicemail, and the T-Mobile Tuesday app. I was not able to find any issues using these apps or the included features. If there are any apps that you feel I should have tested as part of this video, make sure to let me know in the comment section below. I also make sure that the Wi-Fi calling and Hotspot were working. By going to the Settings app, clicking on More, under Wireless and Networks, we can see the connection preference for Wi-Fi calling. I usually have issues with the connections while using Wi-Fi calling, so I prefer to have the setting to cellular network prefer. That way, it will only use the cellular network for calls and it will only use the Wi-Fi calling when the cellular signal is unavailable. Same for Hotspot. You can access it by going to the Settings app, click on More under Wireless and Network, and finally go to Tethering and Mobile Hotspot. From here, you can enable or disable the Mobile Hotspot feature that allows other compatible devices to use your mobile's data connection from T-Mobile to connect to the internet. Last, if you're not very happy with the stock Android launcher included with MetroPCS, you can always install a different launcher. One of my favorite ones is the Nova launcher. You can download the free version and it will work just fine, especially if you're tired of the Google search bar that shows in the main screen, which won't let you remove it. Using different launchers, like Nova launcher, will allow you to get rid of it. Now let's talk about my overall experience. One thing I can tell you is that I put away my Samsung Galaxy S8 Plus for a week while I was using the ZTE Zmax Pro with the T-Mobile network, and I can tell you I was pretty satisfied with the functionality. I never had issues with the network or any issues with the apps crashing as a result of the incompatibility. The performance of the phone was good, connectivity phone calls were also consistent, and the data connection never let me down. Now it's your turn to tell me if you own a ZTE Zmax Pro for MetroPCS and if you're planning to use it with T-Mobile or are currently using it with T-Mobile. Make sure to leave me your experience, questions, comments in the comment section below. Also, make sure to hit the like button if you enjoyed this content and consider subscribing for a weekly tech video. Thank you for watching and I'll see you on the next one.